Let me pull up. So I'm coming on early. Welcome everybody. I see Joey's here. We got a bunch of people watching. Questions? Otherwise, I'll pull up my survey stuff because I have a bunch of survey questions too. But going back to your question, Joey, because people are just jumping on. So be more specific about building a program. I just literally, it's what is it here? 9 o'clock Central. Hey, Brad, did you guys play in the somebody from Aquinas, did you guys play in the Midwest Classic? And how did you do? That was a great tournament. We went to that. That was in La Crosse. I can open this up too if people want to talk. I'll open a seat up. Doesn't have to just be me talking. So if you're feeling brave and you want to jump into a seat, go right ahead. But I'm going back to Joey's question about building a program. So are you talking about from the ground up? Are you talking about the youth? Are you talking about so let me know what you're thinking and I can definitely help it. We did, and we and didn't do too well this year, only put up 22 points. We'd love to get Memorial back up here. You know, we'd love to come back up. I'm still working on next year's schedule. We're gonna have a really good. We got my top seven are juniors, so you see what little hair I have. It's because most of it's been lost this year. Yeah, I don't know what our schedule is gonna look like next year. I'm still kind of working on that. We went to Florida this year. That was a great trip, but let me just pull couple things I need up. Were you guys the last game? What was the last game? And Joey, did I answer your question? Those are the two things. So I'm writing some stuff down so I remember it, so I'm not ignoring you guys. I like this. I don't know if anybody was on last week. Last week we used Hangouts, and I don't know if people like Hangouts better. I'm not sure, to be honest with you. I'm kind of going back and forth between the two. Which one's necessarily better. So, hold on. Right. I'm going to pull up my Survey Gizmo stuff because I know we're still a little early here. But people are coming back in. So, Joey, go back to your, hopefully you're still on. Go back and ask your question again. And I can definitely respond it. If somebody wants to jump on and ask a question, go right ahead. I'm more than willing to run the thing. I'm not sure what these little clappy things down here are either. Maybe see if I can get it. This thing. Oh. So that must be like, because I've never, I the only reason I know this is because of PGC. What's the like question mark thing? We loved it. We loved going to that. Hold on. So Coach Market, I'm talking about Hangouts. Oh, I gotta talk about that too. Hey, before oh, it's a like. It is a like. I think it is a like. So it's like it's like the hearts on it's like the hearts on Periscope. It's not bad for an old man to know all this stuff. So explain to me, Joey, what the FHSAA is. That's like our WIA, which has obviously made the news a lot. So I think that's the first push is the what kind of schedule do you play too? So I, that would be my first. Is there hope for that? We were just down in the villages. Played in the tournament in the villages. It was great. We would definitely go back to that. Got to take the boys to Universal and do all that. That was so much fun. So we got Brad on, we got Joey on. Who else we got on? Anybody else? So going back to your question, Joey, about the youth program and stuff, it's doable. Trust me, building a program is doable from someone that's done it. It just takes, like I said, losing a lot of hair and time. So I'll put it on my list. I have basically the breakdown of how kind of I did it, how I broke the youth program down, what I expected from kindergartens first all the way through season stuff. It'd be good. It'd actually be something good to put on my website. So I'm gonna try to do that. I'm gonna give you my email address. Anybody else has questions? I'll give you a couple of them. And then email me and I'll try to send it off to you. The first one would be collinsbasketball at gmail.com or Steve at coachmarket.net. Steve at coachmarket.net. What are some things you do with our K through 12? K through, so kindergarten, first and second. Great question. First thing you got to do with K first and second is make it fun. I swear to God. And you can only keep them busy for about 5 minutes. We were just talking about this at my youth program. I just got back from my meeting Sunday nights. Once a month, we meet to get together to talk about our youth program. For K through two programs, if you're thinking, are we thinking high school? If we're thinking high school, you definitely want to make it available, make it free. I think that's a great way to kind of to do it. Get them in, get them involved. You're not gonna make a buck on kindergarten, but you got to get them hooked quickly. I would do at that age, I wouldn't do any shooting. You're gonna have to because they want to, and you might need to get a one of those. We have a hoop that hooks to the basket that comes down. But you definitely want to make it fun. You want to make it engaging for them. So lots of dribbling, dribble tag, keep away. You ever play Pac-Man? That's a great drill. I can explain that. Hey Henry. So those would be things I would do for a K2 program. I would do a lot of dribbling because literally you're LeBron if you can dribble at the younger ages. So I'd spend a lot of time on ball handling. And I think we're still a couple minutes away from going live. So let me pull up some of my stuff and then people can keep shooting questions at me. There we go. So when I'm looking over here, I'm not looking off into the sky. No teaching certificate. All right, so give me location. Give me age, give me experience, and I can kind of go. I would volunteer. I mean, without knowing anything else, and is it, I don't have a name there, so I can't call you by name. Without having anything else, I gotta log in here. I would volunteer. That's what I did in my first gig. I volunteered and it gave me I'm pulling up my questions here, some of the questions from my survey. It was the best way to get in. I did that when I was in Appleton, volunteered. Oh, I was playing at the time too, which is, I don't know how I did that. And then it allowed me to, get a little experience, so that'd be my first thing is try to find a good program, find a good coach you respect and volunteer and help out. Maybe go scout, maybe come practice if you're a player. So that'd be the first couple things if you want to get into this game. Volunteer at camps, mid-40s, working with youth as individual skill trainer. Sorry, I'm a slow typer. Birmingham, I love Birmingham. That's a great, I think I'm telling you, volunteers. That's what Brad just wrote. I think volunteers is the way to go too. I really do. They're always looking for. I got a UW student, University of Wisconsin student, volunteering, helping out. You just emailed me 35 seconds ago. All right, so we're still about 5 minutes away. So I'm gonna come back to you about the thing. My son just got home, and he's in eighth grade, and they just won their tournament in, I think they were in Grafton. So I haven't seen him all day. So if the noise picks up, I'm in my office right now. But anyway, my office is great. If anybody likes, here I can show you. So I'm a big reader, you can tell. That's my library shelf of books. I love to read. I wish I had more time to read. All right, so let me. I haven't forgotten about. They're gonna come open. Is the front door open, Maya? All right, I'm gonna be back. I'll be back. 2 minutes. Do not leave. Do not leave. Okay, so of course, they had to come through the garage. So I ran to open the front door and they're not there. So let me go back to I don't know, the guy from Birmingham. He didn't leave his name there, but I would definitely volunteer. I would also go try to get an AU chick gig. That would be from someone that's done personal training himself. I think that's a great way to learn the game. You can definitely out coach people in the summer if you want. But yeah, definitely the high schools. We have a big rivalry game coming up. The opponent may have an edge mentally over my boys because they are a powerful team. Okay, so YouTube's a great way for motivation. You got to sell them. So we have a big rivalry game coming up too. It must be rivalry week. Rivalry week. Can't talk today. But anyway, I would spend a lot of time talking about that they're prepared, that they're ready. Hold on, I'm gonna get. Hey, nice job. Let me see. All right, I'm on a blab right now, so just so you know. So if you get on TV. Nice. Well, what was the final score?
We won by six,
Oh,
so it's a
all
tough
right.
game.
Good job.
Yeah.
All right. See you, bud. Close that door on your way out.
What was it?
Yep. Thanks. So you just want to coach past the AAU thing. Yeah, I would try to volunteer. The NFHS thing is awesome. You know who else runs a really good, I'm guessing it's Phil. You know who else runs a really good thing if you're trying to get into this game is USA Youth Basketball. Is that right? USA Basketball Youth or USA Basketball. They run a great they kind of talk about the non-coaching part, the safety part, and then they talk about the basketball part. I do that. I think that's really good too. That's also there's also certification with that. So I think both of those are really good. Yeah, so I think both of those. If anybody that's coming on, couple things before we get started because we still got about 5 minutes. I'll do an intro at the beginning. We'll talk about some things. I've got some questions people have sent me. We'll do those. I can take questions on the side. We can talk X's and O's for sure. And then I'm looking over here to the side because I got my result, my reports, individual responses. And then we'll do whatever you guys want. I got some ideas. Again, just trying to give a little bit back, and then we'll go from there. We'll see how long it takes. So I'm gonna give it a couple minutes, just check in. I see Phil's on. I don't know. I like this map thing. It's kind of cool. You can kind of see where everybody. I want to see if anybody outside the U.S. is nobody outside the U.S. Oh well. Australia. It looks like I got. Hold on, I'm gonna zoom in. Looks like I got an East Coast. I went to school in USA. Yeah, it's USA. It's USA Youth Basketball. Stuff's really good. I would recommend it. Definitely check it out. I went to Dartmouth. So I've spent some time on the East Coast. I see somebody. We got somebody from the East Coast out there. Tell me from maybe Missouri. I don't know. We got a couple of Wisconsin people. That's good. All right. Couple more minutes. I'm gonna pull up some of my questions that people have sent me. And we'll get situated here. People are joining. Let's see who we got here. We got a hip hop producer. I had Grandmaster Flash's one of his first albums. Does that count? Chris. Chris was the one that asked the question. It does count. I'm glad. I'm old. Heritage. Kissimmee, that's gotta be close to the villages. Is Kissimmee close to the villages? Gotta be. Gotta be close to the villages. You know what? So Brad asked a great question over on the side. Point guard is our biggest hoops junkie. Most skilled, blah, blah, blah. Something John Boyle told me, you can't force the game. You can't force it. Oh, an hour away. Okay. So watch film with him. That's what I have found with my guys that force it. I watch a lot of film. And I basically say, don't go try to do anything you can't do in a game. Just let it come. And trust me, I've had my share of guys that have tried to force the issue. So who else we got on here? We got three visitors that haven't logged in that must just be watching. So they don't want to say anything. So if you want to log in, I'll give you my contact stuff. We got about 3 minutes and we'll get going. I see we got eight or nine people here. That's fine. I don't care. As long as one person showed up, I was going to stay. So Brad's still on. Who left? All right. And I know we've got some other people. Other people planning on joining. I don't know if it's going to work for them tonight. So let me think about. I know people have been asking about the. I know Brad asked that. How can we get him to settle in? So explain more what he's not doing, Brad. And if anybody wants, if you're feeling brave, you can jump in here and talk to me. If you're not. You know why? Because it's the easy way. It's the same reason we have a. It's easy. It's like shooting three pointers. I think I said that at halftime of our last game. It's easy. It's easy to shoot three pointers. It's easy to take that way out. It's hard to run the offense. It's hard to get the ball into the post. It's hard to do all the things that it takes to be a basketball player. That's why people want quick results. And it's building a high school program, building any program, building a business, building, I don't know, Mount Rushmore takes time. And doesn't happen quickly. Like I said, I took the job in 98, and I think the first time we made it was 2004. Yeah, and it's going to take time. I mean, like I said, I'm willing to share stuff with you. I got tons of, maybe we could do you and I could do a conference call. And we could do more, talk more about that. Maybe not this venue. I'm going to wait a minute here and then I'm going to talk about a couple things. I've got questions that people have sent. And then we'll. Ooh, more East Coast. I like that. Somebody up in Maine, I think. Look at that. So who's joined me? Emily joined. Hi, Emily. Mike's joined. Hey, Mike, I have Dr. J's rookie card. So there's I see you're a sports card collector. That's my claim to fame. Boys now don't even know who Michael or Dr. J is, but it is what it is. All right. Looks like we're coming up on. All right. All right, a couple things. I'm gonna go through. If you have questions as I'm doing stuff, shoot it over here. Spread the word. I'm gonna try to do this once a month initially. Hey, Coach, Coach Rock, North Carolina. Duke fan, North Carolina fan, that's the question of the day, I guess, for you. So let me explain a couple things, what I'm going to do. I'm going to give you my email address. I'm going to talk about a couple things. I'll go through some questions. If anybody wants to jump in or show me something or has something that they you can, I left that seat open. If not, I'm more than willing to do this. And then we'll go from there. So I'm not sure how some of you found me through Twitter. Some of you found me through my website. Some of you maybe found me through, hey, Lance. Maybe some of you found me through Facebook, any of those three things, maybe. I have a website, coachmarket.net. It's a hobby. It's fun. I write a blog on there. I do other things just to kind of get back a little bit to this game. So check it out. I think you'll like it. On there, there are a couple things. There are two things. So there's my I have a acquaintance who has videos. I'm selling his videos for him. I have a couple of mine on, but most of them are from Dan Ninham. So they're on there. We make them as cheap as humanly possible. I mean, I think they're $4 to $9. So if you want to check those out, and then my YouTube channel, probably a third of my stuff is on YouTube at this point. If you're looking for drills, I'm going to spend the summer doing breakdowns and things like that. But if you're looking for drills and things like that, go over to Coach Collins on YouTube. There's like 300 videos. So I'm slowly trying to put them into playlists for you. And I'm not being very quick on it because of my team. So I'm doing the best I can on trying to break those down. Rolando, I butchered your name, but sorry. Rolando, I had a Rolando class. But anyway, go to Coach Collins on YouTube. So that's a good place. If you want, I have on my website, if you're on my website for more than a couple minutes, you're going to get a pop-up. If you want to fill that out, it will automatically send you some out of bounds plays that I like that are used in our conference and some quick hitters. So there's spots on there to fill it out. If you don't want to do that, you can just email me. I'll send them to you. At steve@coachmarket.net, steve@coachmarket.net. I'll send you those quick hitters. Hey, how are you? So if you have any questions, I can do that. For those of you that are looking for coaching apps, coaching things, we can talk about it later, but I'll put some stuff, I'll talk about it at the end, but I have some stuff for Coach Base that I think is good. I can get you discounts. I know the guys that own Coach Base. It's basically a practice planner that can get you 10% off. It's a good gig. Anyway, so questions. Does anybody have any questions? If you have them, you can join in with me or you can type it or I'll answer it. I am thinking of moving toward Look at the maps all spread out. I'm thinking of moving toward maybe doing something online with a – hey, Justin. With a kind of a subscription thing. I have loads and loads of stuff I'd like to give away. So – I'm looking into that. Hey, TK. Somebody's above the rim. What's the hardest thing about coaching? That's a tough gig. What's the toughest thing about coaching? I think the amount of time it takes is the toughest thing about coaching. I think it takes, to be good at it, takes a lot of time. I know my family's had to sacrifice at times just because of the amount of time it's taken me. So I think that's a huge thing about coaching. Parents can be hard. I've won a lot, so it doesn't tend to be as big an issue. And I'm, getting closer to the end of my career than the beginning. But definitely family time. I didn't see my son play today because I was doing some stuff, and he came in here, if you were watching earlier, and pretty happy for what he did. But yeah, I think those are the biggest things. You gotta I used to fish and hunt all the time, and I just haven't had time to do it. So that would probably be the biggest thing. Again, questions, ask them. I will, so again, if you have anything you need, let me know. Going back to what I was talking about, I haven't, there's an app out there that if anybody likes practice planning, it seems like a good one. It's free. You can download it off the web. I can give you a discount if you actually do the yeah, Phil, that's hard. I think specialization has taken over from that. I see you're a girls coach, so probably volleyball is one of your harder ones. So yeah, I would think both of those would be difficult things. I used to go outside. I think, cheerleading. Ooh, cheerleading over volleyball. Phil, are you in the South? I think I know. Get my Dartmouth push in. How do you get your kids to commit just during this? How do you get your kids to commit just during the season with so many distractions out there? Is commitment difficult? So, what do you mean by that? Do you mean, is it hard for me to get them playing basketball all year round, or is it hard for me to get them focused during the season? Because the season isn't hard. And I'm on top of them all the time. There's a great app called Remind.com. It basically sends out a mass text to everybody, and I'm always sending them a quote. If you follow me on Twitter at Coach Collins JMM, is that right? At Coach Collins JMM. I'm sending out tweets and videos and things to motivate them all the time. But you have to, I think the hardest part about getting them to commit is they gotta believe in you first before they'll commit to you. That's one of the biggest things I see. So the Coach Base app is good, isn't it? I think it is too. I'm gonna again, if people email me, I'll send you. I have a discount code that they gave me because I know Keith, the owner. If you send me an email, I'll get you a discount on that app. It's really good. I'm a little biased. I got my some of my plays on it, but I just think the way it organizes it, and they got Stephen Curry's dad on there, which the players have coached have made the NBA. Okay, Wesley Matthews has made it to the NBA. So Wesley started at Utah, then he went to Portland, and now he is, and now he's at in Dallas. And then Vander Blue, who played for the Lakers for a while, and now he's playing for their D League. Those are the two guys. And then Keaton Ankeville is playing overseas, and then I got a bunch of guys in D2. Jaron Mayman just came back and is coaching with me. So as far as players go, so hopefully that answered your question. I can type it in if you want, but so other questions. So here's my thought is, and what I would like this to become, and this is again me driving my son all around the world, is I'd like to build a little small community, not a big one, where maybe we do this, and maybe if someone joins me at some point, we talk X's and O's, and we do stuff. I don't know if people are interested in something like that. But what it would be is it would be like a weekly webinar. I think practice planning is something. Okay. I think it's a great thing. And again, this isn't going to sound something that's going to happen overnight, but maybe set up a private, maybe set up a private Facebook page. I've coached for 30 years. my son, I'm either going to give all my resources to my son or I can give it to other people. So I don't know. It would be great, that's why I put all the stuff on YouTube. It's just because I got all this stuff floating around in here and I got to get it out. So anyway, it's something I'm thinking about. I'm bouncing it around. I'm going to talk to a couple other people about it. And but what I'd like to do is actually, here's what we do in practice. Here's what a practice plan looks like. Here's what my generic practice plan looks like. Here's what we do for free throws. Here's what we do for condition. Here's what we do for preseason. Here's what we do for this, and this. And I think there's a need for it. I think I would keep it relatively small. And what I would like to do is the people that are here right now, I don't know, maybe everybody chip in $4 or $5. You guys are my beta version, and we'll just go. And because there's some software I need to get that would be good. How big's my school? My school is 2,000, 2,000, K, 9 through 12. So we are maybe in the top 10 in Wisconsin's largest schools. So we're a pretty big school. But anyway, so if you're interested in something like that, I know some people have put yes on interested, email me. I'm going to start a list of people that are interested. I'm going to try to keep it really tiny for us to. Oh, you're tiny, tiny. So 650. So that would be one of the smaller schools in Wisconsin because we do our numbers for. So you got to go find the athletes then. That's those smaller grades. 300. Yeah, you'd be in a small division. So you can't lose your athletes. You got to get them out. So I got some good ideas about that. But anyway, so again, if you go and download that app, let me find Keith's thing here. It's a good practice planning app. I like it. I think it's a good one. But let me find Keith's thing here because it kind of helps you organize. If you're looking for drills, if you're looking for stuff, go to my YouTube channel. That's a great spot. If you're looking for more enticing ones, hey coach, how are you? Hold on, let me pull this up. Of course, my phone's ringing, so I'm not gonna be able to answer it. Anyway, hi Kyle, how are you? We're just talking a couple of generic things. So, there's a couple good, really shooting drills that I wanted to talk about. I haven't pulled up. Let me see what Marcus is. So if you go to Coach Base and you look at the practice planner, if you type in Coach Market, they'll give you 10% off. I can give you a link too if you want. Hey, coach. Yeah, last week was good. This week has been a little bit more free flowing. No one's joining me. So I think I like this setup a little bit better. I don't have the, if I wanted to X and O, it's a little bit harder. So I want to find some software to maybe do that. We were talking about trying to get kind of a community together to do this maybe once a month. Even in the off season, probably more than during season because we're all so busy. So what's the app called? So the app is called, let me make sure I give you the right one. So I'm gonna grab my phone. So the app is, and I can send you a link to it too if you send me an email. All right, hold on. I'll get to that. Hold on, 1 second. Hold on, 1 second. Hold on, 1 second. It's called Coach Base is the practice one. So it's the one with the yellow ball and it's free. You get some of the stuff for free. So if you go on, you'll get some of the stuff for free. And then there's a premium one that you have to pay. So you can get some of the stuff for free, which is good. And then if you go to the paid one, it's if you type in Coach Market, they'll give you 10% off. I've been hounding the owner basically to give me, I knew I was going to do this, so I wanted to be able to give you a discount. But if you email me, sorry, got a voicemail. I can send you some stuff. Any good zone continuity sets versus a 3-2? Yeah, have you the X cutting is good. Have you run kind of an overload? The T game does that a little bit. Phil, I have something, but I'm not really going to talk about it over the internet. So, I can send it to you that we use that will work really well. I'm not even going to call it by its name here because I still am coaching. I'm not out yet. So if you email me, I'll send it to you. I'll make sure one of my assistants, we have it on Fast Draw, so I'll send it to you. All right, hold on. I'm going to send that to you. Is it take? Hold on. Oh, Phil, you're on Fast Draw. Okay, so Phil, send me an email to steve@coachmarket.net. I'll send that to my assistant, who's my Fast Draw guru. Because, I mean, I'm semi-impressed that I was able to get here and do this today. and then I want to make sure everybody gets on my list so the next time I do this and we can get together and someone else is going to join me and someone else is going to talk other than just me. We have Fast Scout, too. I like Fast Scout. Hold on, I'm trying to close up here. So I'm going to try to get, I got to get your email down. So I'll send you that link and the, I don't know how to do a link on here, but I will send you that code and stuff and exactly to that site. All right, coach. Yep. You send me an email and I'll send it to you too. 1-2-2. We ran into one in Florida. Cardinal Gibbons ran one against us and we were able to get some decent looks on it. Okay. All right. I have questions I can answer too if other people have stuff, but it's funny how zones kind of freak people out. I was at a game, I was scouting a game yesterday, and the team played a kind of a pack man the first half. And then it was either from Wisconsin, it was some Prairie. They played pack man. And then the second half, they went to a 1-3-1, and they played some zone the second half. Just threw the team for, it couldn't imagine how much it threw them for. All right, so Patrick, I got your email. I'll send you that stuff. And Kyle, I'll send you that continuity. I got your email too. I'll send you that when we get off the air, when I'm done tonight, when I'm not sleeping, I'm watching tape for my next opponent. I'll definitely send that to you. Let me, so if I answered all the questions on the side, because if I haven't, I'm more than willing to answer anything else. And again, what I was talking about is trying to get us all together. What I want to do is be able to, and this is where, you know, I'm going to try to set something up because there is a little expense with this, but because of all you and you're here and you're at least listening to an old man talk, I want to be able to give some back to you guys. So, I'm trying to get everybody's email, and you're going to be my beta. I want to be able to get some software where maybe I could do this and then I could also draw on next to me, or, you know, I could close this up and draw on my computer so that we could really talk X's and O's. Backdoor offense. We run a, well, there's the read and react, but we run a kind of a variation of that. Yes. Lance Perkins is really good. And you know what? He's on Coach Base. He's the international. He does the international basketball stuff. And it's really good. So hold on. Everyone's putting their emails too fast. And I'm not able to write that fast. So when you get off, email me at steve@coachmarket.net. I'm going to try to get these down, but you know, me reading my own writing is I should have been a doctor. Well, for more than one reason, but so yeah, so talking to the people that just came, what I'm thinking of doing is I'd like it to be a little bit more closed. I'd like it to be about us. Just because we're all coaching, we don't want to share our stuff. We're all paranoid. So get a community where it's closed, where it's just us talking. And then we could, I mean, I diagram everything up. I can't really diagram some of the stuff we do right now. Especially like out of bounds plays. I can show you some of anyway, so I think that would be really good. So what I'd like, yeah, and Lance Perkins is really good. If anybody, as anybody does it, but he's the whole international guys. No, spread and go. No, so tell me about your variation on it, because I'm super interested. We run a high, we well, first of all, for 15 years, I was a swing guy. So I was a swing and flex guy, and then this year's team, we just couldn't do it. Just couldn't do it. So we're kind of a motion slash read and react slash backdoor slash attack and react. Is it dribble drive? Is it dribble drive? Because everybody seems to be running dribble drive here now. And we're kind of we, you know. It is. Yeah, so I'm telling you, this is confirmed what I thought, that if we can get, 20 to 30 of us together, talking, doing basketball, talking hoops. The principles are, if you pass and cut and go opposite, if you drive, you kick out and shallow cut, just like, ooh, I like that. Yeah, it's all about spacing, to be honest with you. I mean, it's a 2-on-2 and a 3-on-3 basketball game. That's all this is. And it's about putting them in the right spots. You think about the court, especially in a high school court, you got to space people out. If they get too clumped, it's, and that's where the 3-point line, I think, has helped a lot. Ooh, I like that. I do. I'd love to see that. I would love for us to be able to share that. Right, so hold on. I'll tell you the board thing in a second. Hold on. Yeah, you like that? That's what our court looks like. And then hold And then this is my, so that's my head. See my head? So this would be. And then the back side is here. So we're the Spartans. And it's great. The only thing I would do is make the lane a little lighter. So hold on, let me trying to get people's emails down here so we can stay in touch. And you know what? I believe, oops. So I'm not ignoring you. I believe that, the way you learn, it's the I'm a big PGC guy. I love PGC. I'm a growth mindset guy. I think this is what a great way for us to all get together and be able to talk. And this is where I think if we just started, that's why I think the community, if we could start somewhere where we could just share stuff together, and that's what I'm gonna try to do. That's my goal over the next 3 or 4 months, is to try to get together, get some sort of community. I'm willing to spearhead it. That's kind of me doing my thing. But it's gonna be, I think all of us could get as much out of this when our seasons are over and our heads clear, that that might be as worth, that might be worth as much as anything, to be honest with you. I'm gonna try to, I'm gonna do something and see if it works. But so again, just my thoughts as far as how can we maybe make this better. So hopefully you didn't lose me there. You didn't, good. I'm still here. I'm in the process of trying to maybe I'll do it this other way. Hold on. So I don't know. I just, and if it doesn't work, it's no skin off my, it's no big deal to me if it doesn't work. I just think it would be a great way for us to be able to get together, to talk, to do all the stuff that we're kind of talking about. But anything else? I'm gonna try to, like I said, I would like to do this. I know we're all really busy right now during our season. I would like to do this. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna try to find a way that we can do this once a month. I'm gonna try to find a way that we can, I'm not sure this is gonna be the avenue. Hey, Brad. All right, you're online.
How we doing?
I can't hear you though. All right, hold on. Well, that might work. All right, hold on. All right, let me see. Ooh, I like that.
It's kind of like your opposite slot.
Yeah, it's very similar to it. I go put that back for a second. The spot that we use a lot is that short corner behind the backboard.
Okay.
So the ball reverses. They're saying it's kind of like Brad Stevens' four guard attack. Yeah, right in there is where we use that spot a lot. Leslie told me that was an underutilized spot on the court. I like that. I like that. Oh, you didn't have to leave. I like the cut though. I like that location, because it's really about the it's about that move. It's about the movement. That's what I was telling you that I saw yesterday when I was watching East. What happened here? Okay. Here's a shot of our zone motion continuity. I'm getting feedback. Brad, I'm gonna be getting feedback from you. I don't think it's me. Yeah, hear that? I think that might be you. See, I think there's got to be a way for us to be able to do that online. You know what I mean? That we could sit and look at a drill like that and then break it down rather than have to go back and forth with it. So that's going to be that's one of my goals, is to find a way that we can do that. I'm going to get my assistant coaches on here too. I'm getting feedback. Who else is getting feedback? Brad, you gotta just got a message over there too. I am too. All right, all right. Is it better? Well, I turned my volume off. Here, I'll just turn my volume off. All right, I'm gonna turn my volume off. Is it me? Is it me? It might be me. Great.